Hi, everyone. I'm Martina Castro, the host of the Vivo Songbook. Before we start, you should know this episode contains spoilers. So if you haven't watched Vivo, stop everything you're doing, press pause, and go watch it. We'll be here when you're done.
Is this thing on?
We are going to the Mambo Cabana.
The Mambo the what?
Vivo, this is really important. Martha needs to hear this song.
What difference can one song make?
What difference can one song make? That's the question we're on a mission to answer on the Vivo Songbook, a show where we dive deep into the story and songs of Vivo, the movie from Sony Pictures Animation, now streaming on Netflix. I'm your host, Martina Castro, and today we're going to take a close listen to Inside Your Heart so we can figure out what difference that amazing song makes in the story of Vivo.
Your plane leaves in the morning. Soon the world will see you shine.
We pick up where we left off in episode 4. Vivo and Gabby finally made it to Miami with just a few minutes to go before the show. Meanwhile, Marta is still in her dressing room waiting for Andres.
Come in.
Is he here?
The stage manager gives Marta a newspaper.
Oh, señora, I'm so sorry.
On the front page, Marta sees a photo of Andres, a little kinkajou on his shoulder, and the headline, Fallece en La Habana, el querido músico. The beloved musician passes away in Havana.
Andres.
Marta is heartbroken. Andres is gone. But Marta has no idea that the little kinkajou from the photo is running towards her, trying to deliver one last message from Andres, a love song. Will Andres' song reach Marta in time? Will it carry his love and help her feel better? Can a song heal a broken heart? Today, we're going to find out as we talk to Cuban-American superstar Gloria Estefan, who lent her magnificent voice to Marta in Vivo. We'll learn why Gloria was the perfect person to sing Inside Your Heart and tell Marta's story.
Every time I listen to her sing that song, I get goosebumps and I cry.
We'll also go behind the scenes to find out what it takes to create and perform the ultimate love song.
When I first heard the demo for Inside Your Heart, it twisted my heart. It moved me and it made me want to be the one to sing it.
I mean, Gloria is one of the most incredible singers around. And so it's a thrill to get to write for her. I mean, it really is a bucket list moment to write words and music that she's going to sing.
The power of music to heal a broken heart, coming up on the Vivo Songbook. Remember the director and writers of Vivo, Kirk D'Amico and Quiara Alegria Hudes? Well, there's something we haven't told you yet about them. They are both hopeless romantics. So when they started working on Vivo, they thought,
if it's a musical, it should be about love and romance. And so the idea was, what if it was about delivering a love song?
To make their most romantic story wishes come true, Kirk and Quiara turned to Lin-Manuel Miranda.
I showed Lin the script. He said, Quiara, you're setting me up here. I have to write the best love song now.
Yeah. The challenge of Inside Your Heart was, it was just written as the in the script as the most romantic song of all time. Like, no pressure. When I was separated from the love of my life, I wrote the most heartbreaking song of all time, and it's been in a drawer for 50 years, and you have to deliver the song. So no pressure as a songwriter.
Writing the world's greatest love song. Now, that's a tall order. But Lin-Manuel Miranda got to work, and Inside Your Heart was born.
Wow. She never got to hear it. That's so sad.
But the perfect love song also needed the perfect performer. For Kirk, it was an obvious choice.
Marta's gotta be Gloria Estefan. Marta's gotta be Gloria Estefan. Marta's gotta be Gloria Estefan.
Gloria Estefan probably needs no introduction, but just in case.
I'm a singer. I've been around for a bit. You know, got a few hits. If you don't know me, you'll know this one. Come on, shake your body, baby. Do the conga.
Gloria Estefan has more than a few hits. She has 3 Grammys, 4 Latin Grammys, a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame, a Presidential Medal of Honor. I mean, una diva total. But her story starts far from all of this, in Havana, Cuba, on an airport runway. That's where, when Gloria was just 2 years old, she and her mom hopped on a plane to Miami, a short flight away, but a world apart.
For our parents, they thought we were going back in a matter of months.
But it would be a very long time before they could go back, even for a visit.
So that made my mother cling viciously, ferociously to everything about Cuba, our food, the music.
For a while, Gloria's father and her beloved grandmother stayed behind in Cuba. But Gloria's grandma wasn't going to let this separation keep her from spoiling her granddaughter. She would do whatever it took to send Gloria special treats, little pieces of Cuba, to the U.S. She would prepare a box, and then
she would show up at the airport and shove it on any pilot coming to Miami, and she found a way to do it. And in those boxes, she would put my mom's records, 2 and 3 at a time.
2 or 3 records at a time, Gloria discovered famous musicians from Cuba.
My mother had music on in the house constantly. Celia Cruz, Olga Guillot, Cachao, and his orchestra. She would dance around the apartment and sing for me, and I'm there watching my mom, like, in love. This, my mom is so beautiful, and she's the diva. My mother absolutely loved music.
In these moments with her mom, Gloria found pure joy in music. She became obsessed.
I was in love with pop music. So I'm this young girl that would sing with my guitar in my room locked up, getting my cassette. So I'd record Elton John, Stevie Wonder, The Beatles, Carole King.
And one day, when Gloria was just 17 years old, she met someone who truly saw her passion and talent for music, a young man named Emilio Estefan. Together, they started a true musical revolution.
Emilio's band only played Cuban standards, and I said, well, look, why don't we add some disco that was starting at the time, pop stuff and Stevie Wonder, and so all of a sudden we branched out.
So Gloria and Emilio decided to give the band a new name, Miami Sound Machine, and they started making a new kind of music, part Latin, part pop. At first, people told them their new style just wouldn't work.
You're too American for the Latin, you're too Latin for the Americans. We said, that's who we are.
And guess what? It did work. In the 80s, Miami Sound Machine made it big with hit songs like Conga and Rhythm Is Gonna Get You.
Sounds from the 1980s that dominated radio and MTV.
So our culture is what caused our success.
And Emilio and Gloria, well, they became lifelong partners in music and in love. They took the world by storm. They even created their own studio in Miami for musicians who wanted to do things differently, just like them. And that made Gloria and Emilio quite famous in Miami.
Miami is a part of who I am, both musically, in my heart and my soul. I think it's as close as we can be to Cuba and still be in the United States. I absolutely love Miami.
Eventually, Gloria became a solo artist, made many more albums, toured the world. Basically, she became a Cuban-American musical legend.
I can't think of a time in my life where Gloria wasn't part of the sonic landscape. And I remember, you know, dancing as hard to Miami Sound Machine as a kid as my kids are dancing to my own drum when they hear it in the movie.
So it's no wonder the Vivo filmmaking team immediately thought of her when it came time to find the voice of Marta. But first, they had to get her on board. This is Lisa Stewart, one of the producers of the movie.
We always wanted her. And she was like, I'm too busy. And we just persisted.
Then one day, Kirk went to see a musical on Broadway. All of a sudden, walking in the lobby, guess who he saw? Gloria Estefan. And he just went for it.
I just walked up to her and I was like, hello, my name is Kirk, and I'm directing this, and I'm working with Lin.
That's the truth. That is the truth. And I'm going, Vivo movie? What Vivo movie?
When she got home, Gloria asked for more details. She was interested, but she wasn't sure she'd have enough time to prepare. So her first thought was to say, no thanks. But then...
When I first heard the demo for Inside Your Heart, it twisted my heart. It moved me, and it made me want to be the one to sing it. I only heard it once, and it kept replaying in my head over and over. It wouldn't go away.
Gloria fell in love with the song. It was special for her in so many ways. First, there was the melody.
The melody is complex, yet it is so easy to remember. It's like, when the plane lands on the runway, keep this song inside your heart. Oh, when the Jason, da-da-da-da. It doesn't repeat anything. And yet, it leads you down this very beautiful melodic path that you remember.
Then there were the lyrics. They settled in Gloria's imagination and made her really connect with Marta.
A plane and a runway to a Cuban is an imagery that is heartbreaking. Everyone remembers when they left. So in her and Andres' story, you have a microcosm of what most Cubans have lived in some way.
A melody that twists your heart. Words that tell a true story. And the perfect voice to sing it. But to bring a song to life, to really bring it into existence, you need one more thing.
My name is Alex Lacamoire, and I am the executive music producer of Vivo.
You might not know Alex Lacamoire's name, but for sure you have listened to his music. He has worked on many Broadway musicals and movies, including Hamilton and In the Heights. On Vivo, he's a musician, composer, orchestrator, and that means...
Lin will compose the music and the lyrics and the chords and decide that this is a song for Vivo, decide that this is a song for Gabby, and say, I want my own drum to sound like a hip-hop song, or I want Mambo Cabana to sound like an old-school Cuban song.
Alex's job is to turn these ideas, these chords and lyrics, into the full expression of that song. To do that, he has to figure out how many instruments should there be on this song? How will they be played together? Or...
Do we have Cuban instruments on this, or do we use a symphony on it? And how do we teach it to the actors? When do we go to the studio to record the actors to sing it? Should we change the key to make it fit their voices better?
For Vivo, Alex rehearsed and recorded the songs with the actors. That meant that Alex and Gloria spent a lot of time working on Inside Your Heart. First, they worked remotely. And then, when the time came to record the song, Alex flew down to Miami to join Gloria in her famous studio.
It's not too late.
He dug right into it. And I'm good.
La, 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 la.
I feel so lucky that I got to be in the room with her, watching her record that and working with her. It is something that I will remember as a highlight of my entire life, to be working with Gloria Estefan on that.
He's such a great producer and musician as well. And I was very proud. He's a Miami boy, you know, like, so it was Miami in the house all the way. And it was an incredible experience.
I can't overemphasize what it means to hear an artist of her caliber and an artist who is Cuban, who is in Miami and represents Miami. There's just some magic that she brings in.
It's the best three chords ever.
Yeah.
So. Yeah.
All right. So
that's the idea.
In that special combination of Lin-Manuel's writing and Alex's musical arrangements, Gloria could hear the instruments, rhythms, and styles she had loved growing up.
The music isn't watered down. It isn't changed. It's legit what it has to be. And it's still modern. He's still got that modern edge. Because, you know, leave it to Lin-Manuel to be able to ride that, you know, fine line between authenticity and being modern.
And Gloria got to bring in her own special touch on the song as a singer, performer, and actor.
How is this line? What intention do you want behind it? Because both in a musical and in a movie, you're advancing story with each song and you're advancing the character. And every word that you sing is an opportunity to show who that character is.
Que diga presente.
Marta is kind of the embodiment of the Cuban spirit in my mind. You know, she knew what she wanted and she went for it when she got this invitation. At the same time, she was also very vulnerable because she was in love with Andres.
Your plane leaves in the morning. Soon the world will see you shine. And I wish I could go with you. But your journey isn't mine.
I realized that if I told her what was in my heart, she might not follow her heart. So I kept my feelings to myself and said nothing.
And you see in the movie her look of dejection and kind of disappointment when she's standing in the door of the plane looking back at him wondering, hey, you know, this was your shot and you didn't take it.
When your plane lands on the runway, keep this song inside your heart. Oh.
All my love, all my sadness, I put it into a song. It was a song too painful to play. A song Marta would never hear.
It's a very emotional connection that they have and that they each held inside their heart for so many years.
Andres had every intention of delivering this song to Marta himself, of letting her know that he loved her back then and still does today, after all these years. But Marta doesn't know any of this. All she knows is that Andres is gone, and so is her will to sing.
I understand, but Marta is taking this really hard. Yes, she says she can't go on.
Marta loses her voice. Can you imagine? For that to happen to a diva like her on the day of her last show? But Gloria totally understands Marta and connects with her in this moment. She knows just how much your voice can be connected to your heart.
I lost my mom 3 years ago, and for a year I couldn't sing. There was no way that I could do justice or complete my purpose of bringing joy to people when I was so much in pain.
Right around that time, Gloria was supposed to record a new album, but she couldn't sing until something finally shifted. Gloria found her way back to her memories of her mother's joy through music.
And then the joy that my mother brought me became a part of the joy of that album, and the memories of her with time have become more memories of the happiness with love instead of with pain.
This shift Gloria is talking about, it also happens for Marta when a little kinkajou shows up in her dressing room on the night of her last concert with Andres's song in his hands.
He never told me he felt this way. I love you too, Andres. Oh, Vivo, thank you.
This is a song about what the movie's about, which is to continue to keep going, and that music is forever and love is forever. I'm not with you, but I'm with you. I'm always with you. And that's what Marta needs to hear in that moment, and it's also what Vivo needs to hear.
We leave this life, someone new is born, and every relationship is a beautiful learning experience. And when you love someone, that never goes away just because they're not around.
Receiving the song allows Marta to see past the loss and remember the love that she shared with Andres.
And here I thought this concert was about saying goodbye to the old songs. But now, I have a new song to sing.
Then, all of a sudden, Marta finds her voice again.
Oh my gosh, one song can make such a difference. And it's not just one song, it's one song at a time, because songs are going to be transformational in your life.
That's right, just like that. One song can change everything, even in a difficult time. A song can fill a broken heart with joy and maybe even heal it. Next time on the Vivo Songbook, Vivo has accomplished his mission. But where does he go from here? With Andres gone, will the new friendships he made along the way help him find a new place in the world?
Did you get the song to Marta? You did it! That's right. We did it.
For our last episode of the series, we dig deep into one more song. We'll get to hear even more from Alex Lacamoire about the big musical project that was Vivo.
I think the power of one more song is the storytelling of it. Vivo is lost at the beginning, but by the end, he knows exactly how he's going to move forward, and he has a mission.
The power of music to help you find your place in the world. Next time on the Vivo Songbook. And don't miss our latest bonusode. We'll show you how you can make your own melody with the one and only Gloria Estefan. Oh, and of course, if you want to spot all the things we talked about in this episode, you can still watch or rewatch or re-re-rewatch Vivo, streaming now on Netflix.
Your plane leaves in the morning. Soon the world will see you shine.
This episode of the Vivo Songbook was written by Martin Chaussard, who's also our lead producer and sound designer. Our editor is Natasha Ruck. Luis Gill is our production manager and mastering engineer. And we had additional mixing and sound design from Giovanna Romano Sanchez. Special thanks to Adonde Media's Mariano Pachela, to Garth Burkhard and Paige Borsos from Sony Pictures Animation, Charlie Yater from Sony Music, and to our consultants, Natasha Crandall from Crandall Consulting, and Andrew Barkan and Polly Hall from the Ear Snacks podcast. And most importantly, thank you to the entire Vivo filmmaking team. The Vivo Songbook is produced by Adonde Media for Netflix and Sony Pictures Animation. I'm your host and executive producer, Martina Castro. Nos vemos.
When the road goes only one way, keep the song inside your heart. Oh, when the years pass, but the love stays, keep the song inside your heart. Oh, I'll be with you when this song plays all along inside your heart.